At his first rally in the aftermath of Sandy, Mitt Romney steered clear of any direct attacks on the president. But it was clear the political winds were picking back up again as Romney tried to tie the nation's storm response to Election Day.
Now, people coming together is what's also going to happen, I believe, on November 7th.
Then he made a segue back to his campaign's closing argument.
I don't just talk about change. I actually have a plan to execute change and to make it happen.
For Romney, it's a delicate balancing act. As one of his top surrogates, New Jersey Governor Chris Christie tours storm damage with President Obama after praising the administration's response. On a three-stop swing through Florida, Romney had other big-name supporters at his side, namely the state's former governor, Jeb Bush.
Thank you, Marco.
Who appeared to take a dig at all of the attention paid to the president's handling of Sandy.
My experience in this emergency response business is that it's the local level and the state level that really matters. That if they do their job right, the federal government part works out pretty good.
With less than 1 week to go, the Romney campaign is trying to expand the battleground map from the eight states both sides agree are in play to opportunities Republicans now see in Michigan, Minnesota, and Pennsylvania.
They're defending territory while we're on offense.
On an Obama campaign conference call, the president's top advisors coined a new term for that.
This professed momentum of the Romney campaign is really fomentum.
In Ohio, the Romney campaign is running a radio ad that claims the president is allowing U.S. automakers to shift jobs to China.
Barack Obama says he saved the auto industry. But for who? Ohio or China? Now comes word that Chrysler plans to start making Jeeps in, you guessed it, China.
The ad builds on a story Romney told last week in Ohio.
I saw a story today that one of the great manufacturers in this state, Jeep, now owned by the Italians, is thinking of moving all production to China.
After Jeep's owner Chrysler came out to say the story is false and that the company is actually adding jobs in Ohio, the Obama campaign has seized on the moment as an act of desperation.
That's what the ad says. It's an outrageous lie.
A top Romney advisor defended the campaign's advertising on the auto bailout, but that same advisor would not say whether or not the GOP nominee agrees with Chris Christie's praise of the president's handling of Sandy. Jim Acosta, CNN, Jacksonville, Florida.